Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you all? Hope you are all fine. Welcome to your science online class. This is your book of science, science book 3. Open up chapter number 1. Chapter number 1 was about ourselves. We were reading the chapter number 1. We have already discussed the topics. Our human body. We have already discussed about what are our skeleton systems. Our muscles, the structure of muscles, the types of muscles. Today, open up page number 5. We are going to start our topic, some sensible organs and their functions. Okay, class, I hope you know about what are the sensible functions, what are the sensory functions in our body. It will be clear to you from your from the following picture. For first, your first sensible organ is, sensory organ is nose, and then eyes, ears, tongue, skin. These all are the sensory organs. Now let's read what are the functions of the sensory organs. First is nose. What does nose help us? Nose help us in smelling. What does ear help us? Ear, we can hear with our ears. We can see with our eyes. We can taste with our tongue, and we can feel with our skin. So what is the sensory functions of the sensory organs? Nose function is smelling, ear function is hearing, eyes function is seeing, tongue function is tasting, and skin function is feeling. Okay, class, I hope you understand. Now move to the next page, page number 6. Now we will read about the role of brain in the use of senses. Our sensory organ functions as receptors and receivers. Our sensory organs, we have read about the sensory organs, that our sensory organs, for example, the nose, ears, eyes, skin, these are all the sensory organs, and these all functions as receptors and receivers and receptors. Yani receptors means to receive something and receive the stimuli. Our ear detect the stimuli. Our ear detect the stimuli means that our ear detects the voice that is coming from outside when we are hearing something. The way the stimulus travels through our body is described below. Here is the function of the stimuli. Okay? After our sensory organs, now I will help you to explain this diagram from the following passage. After our sensory organ received the stimuli, it sends the nerve impulses to the brain. For example, you can see in the picture that this is the sensory receptor. Sensory receptor, for example, our skin, our hand is the skin is the sensory organ, and it received a bit effect from the heat of the candle. So we can say that it is the sensory organ receptor, and after receiving this effect of hand from the candle, it uses the nerve impulses. These red and blue are the nerve impulses in the picture. These red and blue are the nerve impulses in the picture, and the it uses the sensory organ uses the red and blue nerve impulses to send the message to the brain that our hand, our sensory organ has received an something effect. Now then you can see, look at the picture that it is written, that you can see in the passage that it is written, it sends the nerve impulses to the brain, which then interprets it means translate the message of the nerves, and then decide what to do. After the brain decide what to do, it then send this after the brain these nerve impulses send the message to the brain that our hand, our sensory organ has received some of the effect from the candle, and then the brain decide that what to do. The brain decided after deciding what to do, it then said the nerve use the nerve impulses to do the related effector. Means that these nerve impulses then send the message back to our hand that what it should do. Some examples of the factors are muscles and brain. Okay, I hope you understand. Now we move to our next topic. It is the health and diet. Health and diet. We need food in some same way that a car need petrol and do. To grow healthy, we should eat the healthy food. It is explained here that we need the food in same way that the car need the petrol. Our body uses up energy every day, and we can get the energy when we eat the food, not only to walk or exercise, but for everything. Our body is still using up the fuel when it's asleep, as our heart and other organs are still working. Means that the food is very important thing in our body, and we can get energy, and we can grow if we eat the healthy food every day. Now let's talk about the balanced diet. What is the balanced diet? The diet that contains the adequate amount of all the necessary nutrients required for the healthy growth and activity is called the balanced diet. A balanced diet contains the sufficient nutrients from all the food groups. What are the food groups? There are five main food groups. Let's discuss about the food groups. The first group of the food contains fruits, vegetables, milk and dairy products, meat, fish and beans. Grains include the bread, rice and pasta. These all are the five groups of food that provide you the nutrients that are necessary for your healthy and balanced diet, and that gives you the energy for growing up. Now we will discuss about the importance of food group. What are the importance of food group? Number first is fruit, vegetable, milk and dairy products, meat, fish, egg and beans, and grains, bread, rice and pasta. Class, you have to read these passages very carefully, and you have to know what are the importance of these five groups in our daily life, and what amount of fruits we should take daily, what amount of vegetables we have to take daily, and we have to balance such a diet in our life that it gives you energy and helps you to grow up. And I hope you will read these passages very carefully and know what things we have to do, we have to take in our meal daily to grow up and to get energy. And you have to read these all fruit, vegetable, milk and dairy products and these all five groups very carefully, and send me the feedback that you have read them very carefully. Okay class, thank you very much. Allah Hafiz.